Fruits are healthy, right? That's what we've been told since childhood. But when it comes to blood sugar, not all fruits are created equal. Some barely affect glucose, others hit like dessert. So I decided to test it. I used my Dexcom continuous glucose monitor to track how 17 different fruits affected my blood sugar. I tested only the fruit. No added sugar, no protein, no fat, just the fruit itself. Most servings were close to 150 calories, but a few a bit more, like bananas, grapes, mangoes, and green pears, to keep the portion realistic. And the results? Some were exactly what I expected. Others totally surprised me. Here's how I ran each test. I ate the fruit, tracked my blood sugar every 5 minutes for 2 hours, and recorded the spike, how long it took to peak, and how quickly it returned to baseline. I set the glucose graph for every fruit, so I could compare the responses side by side. Let's go to the results, from the most gentle to the most extreme. Strawberries got the lowest spike, 113. That was from 150 calories and 23 grams of sugar. Really stable. Next was blueberries, with a spike of 122. Same calories, 24 grams of sugar. Very mild. Apricots came in at 135, with 29 grams of sugar. Papayas hit 146, with 27 grams of sugar. Red apple spiked me to 148, slightly more calories and 160 with 32 grams of sugar. And just to visualize that, 32 grams of sugar is about 9 sugar cubes. That's what's hiding in a big apple. Red cherries and figs both peak at 156. Cherries had 37 grams of sugar, figs had 32. Kiwis spiked me to 159, only 22 grams of sugar, one of the best overall performers. Then came the mid-range fruits. Honeydew melon caused a spike of 164 with 35 grams of sugar. Jackfruit was next at 166 with 30 grams. Green pears gave a spike of 176, 174 calories and 29 grams of sugar. Plums spiked me to 183 with 150 calories and 30 grams of sugar. These were very ripe, which likely made the spike sharper. Now the high spike group, mangoes hit 184. That was a big portion. Two champagne mangoes, totaling 243 calories and 48 grams of sugar. That was the highest sugar load in the entire experiment. And to picture that, 48 grams of sugar equals about 14 sugar cubes. That's a lot. Oranges were a big surprise. Only 112 calories and 22 grams of sugar. But my glucose spiked to 215. That one caught me off guard. Grapes caused a spike of 225. With 187 calories and 42 grams of sugar. Watermelon peaked at 227 from 150 calories and 30 grams of sugar. And bananas were the heavyweight, a spike of 242 from 242 calories and 34 grams of sugar. These were very ripe bananas, soft, sweet, and clearly very fast absorbing. Looking at all the results side by side, one pattern stood out immediately. Tropical fruits like mangoes, bananas, jackfruit, papayas, watermelon cause the highest spikes. They're sweet, juicy, and loaded with fast-absorbing sugars. Some of them, like mangoes and bananas, also have the biggest portions, which made the spikes even stronger. On the flip side, berry performed the best. Strawberries and blueberries had the lowest spikes at all, even at the same calorie level. So if you're trying to enjoy fruit while keeping blood sugar in check, berries and kiwis are your best friends. Tropical fruits, handle with care. Or at least keep portions small and timing smart. There are a few more takes away from all this. First, sugar content matters, but it's not the full story. Portion size, fiber, and glycemic load all play a role. Some fruits with less sugar cause bigger spikes than expected, and vice versa. Second, ripeness matters a lot. The riper the fruit, the faster that sugar hits your bloodstream. That's especially true for bananas, grapes, mangoes, and plums. Third, individual response matters. These were my numbers. Yours might look different, but I hope my data gives you a helpful reference. Just for context, my A1C is 5.3%, so I am not diabetic, not even pre-diabetic. But this blood sugar spike still means my body is not handling glucose as well as it could. It usually takes years for spikes like this to turn into pre-diabetes. I'm not stressed about it, but it can still cause issues now, like fatigue, suppressed HGH, and more inflammation. That's why I try to minimize them when I can.
I'm not stressed, not at all. No, I'm not stressed, I'm fine, I'm good.
Okay, that's it for today. I hope it was helpful. This one of my favorite self-experiments. Simple, practical, full of surprises. If you're curious about how fruits affect your blood sugar, try testing a few yourself. Whether you manage energy, weight, or just curious like me. Knowing your own response is incredibly useful. And if you like this video, hit like and subscribe to our channel. I'll be sharing more experiments like this with other foods and drinks soon. Stay curious, stay practical, stay healthy. See you next time. Bye.